I'm Krishna. I live in London with my boyfriend, and I am a transmasculine, non-binary, bisexual, dyslexic performance artist. There's nothing more confusing than performance art. My star sign, my sun is Aries, my rising is Libra. I'm indecisive and I'm stubborn. You're double Aries, which means you're insufferable. A sperm donor because we want to have a baby and we're both trans.
How do people pick sperm donors?
I'm making a show called First Trimester where I sit on stage and interview hundreds of people in the hopes of finding me and my boyfriend a sperm donor, at least finding the qualities of someone that we're looking for. Initially, when we started looking on sperm donor websites, the information that we often got were things like height and eye color and race and whether or not they had PhDs, which were things that we didn't really care about. I said, wouldn't it be amazing if we could speak to hundreds of people and form some sort of real connection with them and at least find out what sort of person they might be before we pick our donor. I would rather them be a nice person than, I don't know, a transphobe that we have to deal with in 18 years. I've got some questions for you.
Hit me.
I'm so ready.
Let's do it.
Sperm donation seems like the best option for us, but it's the relationship with the sperm donor I'm a bit cautious of. I come from a nuclear family, mother and father, brother and a sister, and it's all I've really known. Having a third person stake some sort of claim to our family is a bit threatening for me.
What did I say when you told me about the show?
You weren't so sure. And then you were like, it's fine, but I don't want to be involved. And now you're doing it all that you said you didn't want to do, which is classic you.
Hello.
What are you looking for from a sperm donor? Looking for a sharing?
It depends on the other person. Me and my partner have always said that we would go off the idea that it's a sperm donor who won't have a lot of agency in this specific family unit. If you were to donate to me and my partner, what sort of involvement do you imagine in the future?
To hopefully be my friend. I'd like to be involved in the child's life, and I'd hope you'd want that too.
I feel quite detached from my sperm. Once the sperm's out there, like, there's not a huge amount to do with me.
I guess being like a family friend, right? Like an aunt, like someone they know that they're excited to see.
My partner asked me, why did you want to do this before we came here today? And I said, family tradition. Because I'm actually donor sperm as well. I think part of the contract is I'm gifting this, but it is now yours and it's your child.
So you said you've made some of the questions with your partner. How come they're not here today?
He is, he's just there. I gave him the option to be on stage and he said no, but what he does is sits here every night and heckles me instead.
Would you like animals in your family?
Yes.
I guess your heckling is, it is funny, but I think it's to make a point.
You could look at the heckling as being symbolic of being the non-birthing parent and looking in from the outside, something that's so central to my life, especially because there's this addition of a sperm donor.
It's also a sense of you wanting to control something that you feel like you don't have control over otherwise. I understand from my experience that a parent is just someone who cares for you. I grew up with my mum, a single mother, my older sister, who's 13 years older than me, and my uncle, who isn't biologically related to me, but has always been like my third parent. I feel less strongly about family needing to be connected by blood. It is annoying that then you're the one not carrying the child because I could get more on board as a parent and not have these same fears. Have you thought about donating sperm before?
I have been a donor. It was a family decision, so I spoke with my partner and we also spoke to our kids about it. Ultimately, why I wanted to do it was to help people start families who wanted to.
I've just completed my donation program at the London Sperm Bank. I delayed my hormone replacement therapy to do that.
I think this world, especially this country at the moment, is really scary with kind of trans issues.
I've got lots of fears and apprehension. We're making this show in a very specific climate where we've had to do a lot of safeguarding in terms of how to sort of deal with media and anti-trans rhetoric and TERFs and all these different things that you don't usually have to think about while making a show.
Well, I would like to know one thing you are scared of in this process of finding a donor.
The whole show exists because the fear is that we'll pick the wrong person and then we're stuck with someone in our lives that is the wrong person to have made a child with.
What do you like to do in your free time?
I like to travel, and I also have a little hobby, donating sperm. My sperm count is very high. I just had my 71st sperm donor child born a few days ago, and then I have another 9 on the way, so that's gonna be 80.
Okay, cool.
Some people have this desire to spread their seed.
Yeah, regardless of the potential consequences.
He's quite a common character on, like, Facebook groups that people tend to use for sperm donation.
The systems aren't always set up for queer and trans people, so we feel like we have to go for the most available option, like him, whose intentions might be ego-driven. And laws around the world don't protect us either. Like in the UK, you're allowed to donate to 10 families, but that same person could go to more countries and keep donating. There isn't really a global governance.
Using a sperm bank, that is an option. It's also an expensive one that lots of queer and trans people don't have the financial resource to use or go through this medical system. As trans people, we're already medicalized. It's better to put off being a part of that system for as long as we can. So if we can get pregnant DIY style, that's much preferable than having to deal with doctors who might not necessarily understand our identity or what our bodies need.
Have you pictured yourself with belly? Yes.
I have. It feels like a transformation, a transition, which I've already done.
Yeah.
It feels less scary to have my body change. It's okay, I've done it before. So far, we've done 4 shows, 17 hours, 60 people. I've been surprised by the range of people. I don't think I expected older, straight men to be turning up. Some people are there for a conversation. Some people are there because they've really thought about it and they want to donate sperm. Some people are thinking about being queer parents themselves.
Why sperm donation as opposed to adoption?
I don't necessarily want to carry a child, and if I had the choice, adoption would be the thing I want to do more, but it doesn't feel like they're going to give 2 trans people a child right now. And so the only way I could then be a parent is if I'm going to carry the child myself, which I'm not too thrilled about.
So this is the convenient way of doing it.
Yeah, apparently all this is what it takes to have a child, and that's the easy option. Hi.
Hello.
I'm wondering how you've got to this point where you've agreed to be here.
We were just sitting in the living room one day when you're like, do you think I can get arts funding to talk to lots and lots of people on stage and we can find our sperm donor? And I like flatly said no. Mm-hmm. I'm from New Zealand, but I don't think I realised I had a village in London or a community in London. And I think the more the trans and queer people and parents were coming in and talking about things, I'm like, oh, this is actually kind of meaningful, I think. And everybody who's come in here, nobody has challenged you about being trans. Nobody has challenged us about being trans and wanting parents. People have just gone, oh, I can understand how it's harder for you, and here's my thoughts about parenting generally. Mm-hmm. What have you changed your mind about?
Well, I feel like you changed your mind more than I have. The main thing I've changed my mind about is how much more open I am to the level of involvement that someone might have.
I think the more queer people, especially you spoke to, who were like, it's a gift, I'm just giving this thing, and once I let go of it, it's like nothing to do with me, and I can accept that. But I can also accept being spunkle, gunkle, auntie. I can babysit for you. That has made me think actually everybody's intentions are quite genuine. And I don't normally see the best in people or like value kindness very much, but I think through this process, I'm like, oh shit, actually like kindness is pretty cool. And kind people like make life easier. Mm-hmm. And it seems like there are gonna be lots of kind people around however we get to the end of this. I do still feel threatened by a co-parent, but the uncle who's gonna like bring food over every week and be just a mate, I feel a little bit more open to that. And it almost makes me sad that if we do have to go to a sperm bank through an anonymous donor, like what are we missing out on? Yeah.
Yeah. Do you think we've found someone?
I don't think we've found someone. I think we've found a pretty good selection of people we would go, fuck, we could probably have that person in our life and they would be amazing to have a child with. Maybe. Who is that person? Like, this is the thing, we can't even choose a movie together.
So how are we going to pick a donor? That is...